Hello, I'm Dr. Jim Wells from Tremco Barrier Solution. In this session, we'll be talking about the two different ways to meet residential energy codes. First, there's the prescriptive method. You use a list. The list determines your cost. The second is the performance method. In that method, you choose the best way to build a home with the equal energy performance of the prescriptive home. This method is required by Energy Star and most utility incentive programs, but most importantly, it maximizes the value of your construction alternatives. Energy codes are aimed at limiting energy use or loss. Home heating energy is lost in two principal ways. First, by conduction. Heat is conducted out through the home envelope in the wintertime, or the reverse in the summertime with air conditioning. The second is by air infiltration. Heated or cooled air blows out as the exterior air comes in to replace it. Both of these need controlling. The performance path provides the highest value way to meet these requirements. To understand the difference, we need to look a little bit more fully about the diminishing value of insulation. There's three rules that we should remember. Number one, the first R is the best R. Number two, the value of adding additional insulation diminishes as you increase the insulation level. And number three, to reduce energy loss by 50%, we need to double the R value. All right, to understand this, let's look at a simple example, and we'll look at energy lost through the ceiling. In this simple example, we will have only a 1-inch thick piece of drywall for our ceiling that's initially uninsulated. And let's look at the value of adding additional insulation. By referring to the first row of the table, we notice we have 0 R value added. So we have a total system R value of R1. The BTUs that we're using is 100. And of course, we've saved no energy because we've added no insulation. In the second row, we're going to add R1. Now that doubles our system R value to an R2. So since we doubled our R value from R1 to R2, we've cut our energy loss in half. It went from 100 to 50, so we saved 50. Now we want to save more energy, so we're going to double the R value again. We're going to go from R2 to R4, therefore we needed to add 2 more, so we'll cut our current energy use in half. Well, our current energy use was only 50, so we cut that in half to 25, and we save 25. You notice when we added our first R, we saved 50, but adding 2 more, we only saved 25 BTUs, or 12.5 per R. Now, if we went down to the next to the last row on the table, where we're currently at an R16 for our system R, you notice we're only using 6 BTUs. Now, oddly enough, if we had room enough in the attic to add a million R's if we wanted, the only energy we could save would be those 6 BTUs, because you cannot save any more than you're losing. Now, for the last line, if we finally doubled our R16 to R32, you notice we cut the 6 BTU to 3. So the first R we added saved 50, the last 16 R's only saved 3. Now you might ask, is there a more effective way to save energy? If we looked at air infiltration, there is. As a matter of fact, instead of adding additional insulation, you could reduce the air infiltration in the house to save an additional or an equal amount of energy. Looking at this table, we can see from the example we had, taking ceiling insulation from R38 to R49, equivalently, we could drop our air change measured value from a 7.0 air changes per hour to 6.8. Very modest. As a matter of fact, if we went from R38 to R100 in the ceiling, that would only be equivalent to dropping our air changes from 7.0 to 6.5. If we looked at insulation in our walls, we could go from an R15 2x4 wall to an R20 2x6 wall, or we could achieve the very same energy savings by reducing our air infiltration from 7.0 to 6.1 in a measured test. Notice, you could make all of these insulation and window thermal efficiency changes, or you could simply drop the air infiltration value from 7.0 to 5.6. The most value that you can get from your construction alternative is actually to first focus on air infiltration. Then you can use the insulation and air change trade-off that best suits your building practice. You can meet or exceed energy codes with lower cost. You can right-size your HVAC equipment and maintain comfort. You can stay with 2x4 walls if you like. It's not needed to go to 2x6 or even foam on the exterior of your walls. Using the performance path provides the highest value for current and future energy codes. Energy Raters have the tools to help you meet your energy goals most advantageously. The performance path is your friend.